Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I'm very pleased to be there with all of you. So unfortunately, not physically, but at least virtually. My name is Maxime Hambourg. I'm working in AXA XL and in charge of innovation and business development for our risk consulting organization. So for our today's meeting and Chicago Global Conference, I'm very pleased to present to you our risk scanning offer. So risk scanning, this is the combination of our long-standing risk engineering expertise by trade sector, which has been combined with our risk modeling data analytics expertise. And thanks to the combination of these two expertise, we are very proud to propose to the WBN International Network of Partners risk scanning. So when we started to develop risk scanning, we had certain number of consideration in mind. The first one is that, unfortunately, we are in a context where this is very difficult for us and for our clients to visit physically their sites. And you know better than me that risk is not stopping even during the pandemic crisis. So we wanted to propose to our clients and our partners another way to provide a digital risk engineering solution for our large and corporate businesses. The second consideration in mind is that today, with the potential of tech and data, we have just the opportunity to rethink the way serving our clients in risk engineering. And another consideration in mind is that we are currently facing market hardening conditions, and both insurers and clients, they need to gather additional risk information to better understand the risks that they have and to propose suitable insurance solution and suitable risk engineering solution given the profile of their risk. So what is risk scanning? Risk scanning is a solution which is enabling our clients, our brokers, partners, to assess very large portfolio of sites. How we are going to do that? We are collecting data coming from the clients. We are complementing this data with some external data sources. We have built internally some risk algorithms. And we have used our risk engineering expertise to develop suitable checklist questions depending on the different perils and different occupancies. And I'm going to come back. So the value of risk scanning. So we have five different advantages. The first one is an opportunity to analyze a very broad portfolio of sites. We are speaking potentially about several hundreds, several thousands of sites. And in a very limited time frame, we are speaking about several weeks or even several months in worst cases. This is an opportunity based on data that we are going to collect at client side, once again complemented with some other type of data. We are going to develop risk scores, which will allow us to identify the most risky sites where it makes sense to prioritize risk engineering resources. So it can be used as a prioritization tool. Then it's an opportunity to conduct a multi-peril risk assessment and to go beyond property traditional risk. And I will come back to that. The fourth advantage, it's an opportunity to highlight the risk profile at global portfolio level, at global client level, and the opportunity to look in the detail and to have a specific focus at site level or at risk level. You will see that the offer is very customizable and there is the opportunity to adapt it, making sure that it can fit your needs, it can fit the needs of our client. So once again, risk scanning is a fully digitalized risk consulting service, which is combining our risk engineering expertise, our data mining and digitalization capabilities, and which allows to perform risk assessment and monitoring of very large portfolio of sites by analyzing clients' available data, external additional risk data, and you will see then that this is not only a diagnostic tool, but this is a decision-making support tool because we are sharing with the plant managers, with the clients, some base recommendation measures, thanks to reskilling. So today we have already developed a certain number of risk modules. So what do we call by risk module? The risk module, this is a checklist. So a certain number of questions. We are speaking about 20, 30, up to 50 maximum questions, which will allow us to accurately assess the risk for one given peril. Then we, given our AXA XL claims experience and our risk engineering expertise, we have weighted the different answers to these questions, depending on the variables, depending on the occupancy. So I'm going to take a very simple example. The importance to have a sprinkler system is definitely the same between an office building and a plastic manufacturing. So for each and every perils and for each and every occupancies, we have defined specific risk algorithms, taking into consideration our AXA XL claims experience and risk engineering expertise to properly assess the risk. So all the modules which are available, we already have developed a library of risk modules. So for property-related perils, fire and explosion, machinery breakdown, natural hazard, security, burglary and theft, water damage as well. We have built one specific for environment, health and safety, food liability, art collections. So for art collections which are either located in museums or in galleries, for instance, we have developed a specific risk module for all goods which are stored in storage locations, taking into account the risk of the warehouse of the storage location, but taking into account the inherent risk of the motor fleet and suppliers, meaning that some of our clients are leveraging risk scanning not only for their own portfolio of sites, but even for the portfolio of the sites of their suppliers, first-tier suppliers. And all these risk modules have been developed for different occupancies. So on the right part of the slide, you have all the occupancies which have been already developed. And as long as we are working with new clients, we potentially add new type of risk modules and new type of occupants. So for occupancies, we are speaking about plastic manufacturing, food manufacturing, metalworking, foundry, logistics centers, storage location, warehouses, office buildings, retail shops, airports, hospitals, museums, hotels and restaurants, condominiums, merchants and craftsmen, residential buildings. Once again, this is the first library, which is every day being improved depending on the needs of our client. But today you can see that we have already developed around 12 different risk modules, and for these different risk modules, this is already available for multiple. Then how does it work? How do we propose this risk scanning offer to our clients? So first, we are saying that we are not replacing the traditional risk engineering activities, which are mostly today conducted in the field. So you know how it is going on, especially in property or environment. We are sending a risk consultant in the field. This person is going to assess in detail the vulnerabilities of the site, the potential deficiencies. They are going to assess potential loss estimates, and they are going to propose base recommendation with the cost of implementation, with the loss estimate before, after implementation, and after implementation. So this is a traditional way to conduct the field. So today, we are not replacing this type of risk engineering service. We are complementing this type of risk engineering because, once again, proposing field services to all sites for clients having several hundreds, several thousand of sites, this is not applicable. Same thing for SMEs, mid-market companies, not having the money to conduct field risk engineering activity. This is a great opportunity to start disseminating risk engineering standards for their portfolios. So this is why risk scanning is very much complementary to the other type of services. And when we are deploying risk scanning, you have two main ways to deploy it, either in a fully standardized way with very low, if not human intervention. And you have the hybrid risk scanning version, where in addition to the risk assessment, we are doing some base remotely analysis with an engineer, taking the time to assess in details the data and starting to propose the first loss mitigation strategy to the client. This framework is very much adaptable. Once again, in line with the size of the portfolio, the available resources, the time constraints, the budget, which is existing, opportunity to either deploy the full range of services or only to select one or the other, depending once again on the needs of the client. How does it work very concretely? Four different steps. The first one will be the client onboarding. So we propose all WBN network members to administrate their portfolio of clients. The members of WBN, you know your clients, you have the contact, you have the client, because you have the relationship with the client. The idea will be to have all members fully autonomous in the way to administrate the risk scanning offer. The second step, so the client is going to fill a standard risk questionnaire and access the platform. The only thing that we need is the email address of the plant manager, so the person who is going to fill in the questionnaire. Directly, this person will receive an identifier and the password to access a web-based questionnaire. Is going to answer the different questions. Once again, we are speaking about 30, 50 maximum questions. So globally speaking, we consider that this is requiring 30 minutes up to 1 hour for the most complex questionnaire to fill in the questionnaire. And then on the own, that person will access the platform, the performance of the client, in addition for sure to offer. Accessing all the different results, the different risk variables, risk concerns, and really the identification of the areas which deserve deeper analysis and improvement opportunity, which is about the third step, it's about the risk assessment and analytics. Once again, the broker and the client will access several risk metrics and will be able to identify and to quantify the main risk drivers for the client and for the portfolio. At portfolio level, sorry, and at site level for the client. Last step, opportunity for the client and the broker to access everything into a PDF report, into an Excel spreadsheet with standard prevention suggestions and at least opportunities to identify what should be the relevant actions given the risk profile of the client. So we propose for WBN, sorry, if you see some interest, to deploy the approach in three different steps: scoping, piloting, scaling. For sure, this is something which is potentially big. So we would recommend to start by identifying a reasonable target perimeter where we are going to pilot the value of risk scanning. With few members, only focusing on one simple risk module, fire and explosion, for instance, or property all risk type of questionnaire, where the objective will be to test the robustness of the platform, the relevance of the questionnaire, and in the end, the value for the broker and for the client to benefit of such a service. And then we'll be able to scale either the entire network of WBN or only target members, depending on your appetite and the need to and the potential to access this type of set. What are the benefits? On the left part of the slide, we are emphasizing the benefits for WBN. And on the right part of the slide, the benefits for your customer. The first benefit for WBN. This is an opportunity to collect additional risk size insights from your clients. And today, we are currently in a market hardening condition. Vast majority of insurers are asking more and more risk insights, risk data from their clients to properly structure suitable insurance coverages, suiting their needs and suiting the risk profile. So opportunity for W network members to better document, to better understand and better sell the risk profile of the client towards insurers. The second objective is the platform, the tool is very much flexible. And this is the opportunity to serve several insurance business lines in property, in environment, in motor fleet, in marine cargo. The third objective, the third advantage, opportunity to gain some efficiency. So you might have internally some risk engineering resources. This is the opportunity to provide new ways, digitalize type of services at lower cost. This is something which is quite differentiating on the market. No one, I say no one, is proposing this type of digital risk engineering service. You will see that some brokers, global brokers, some fintech brokers are proposing based risk rating analysis or very simple digitalized risk assessment. But risk scanning is far broader, combining once again data analytics and prevention recommendation. And we keep on developing the platform. So today you have the version 2, which is already available, but we keep on developing and adding new functionalities to this risk scanning offer. An opportunity to really establish WBN network members as being a trusted advisors and leading the market on digitalizing risk assessment, collecting data, and just better serve your partner. On the right path, benefits for the customer. Once again, this is something which can be deployed very rapidly, easy, and globally. So by accessing a single web platform, you can navigate across different perils. You have access to constant risk monitoring. You have the micro to micro view of your portfolio. So it's something which is quite comprehensive and really easy to use for the client. Once again, we already discussed this point. It's an opportunity for the client, benefit of increased risk knowledge on their portfolio. Portfolio of sites, sometimes the sites which are not visited, sites which have never been visited. And opportunity, once again, to start better understanding the local situation, the local practices of the site. Once again, flexible and customized, we have the opportunity for clients having specific needs to adapt the questionnaire, the algorithms, and the platform. Experts by client side. We are not stopping at the collection of risk data. So we are giving the access to the clients and potentially to the network members to access remotely to an industry expert. This industry expert, so this risk engineer, AXA XL Risk Engineer, will share its best practices and will support the broker and the client to manage its risk data. Once again, last but not least, ongoing strategic support, meaning that this tool can be used as a service for the client to get an holistic view of its risk and to start identifying the main risk concerns. at portfolio level, and where there is some dedicated actions which would be of value through e-training, through technical documentation, awareness, communication, and once again, opportunity to identify the sites where in-depth analysis would be required and potentially with some field activity. What are the target segments, the industries where definitely risk scanning is very much relevant? We are seeing that all sites having a TSI, a total sum insured, below 50 million euros are very much eligible to risk scanning. So we are speaking about small and medium-sized companies, mid-market companies, or all global corporates having several hundred, several thousand of sites, where you might have some sites which are far below these 50 million euros of threshold. We are not going to promote risk scanning for very complex sites, for complex energy sites, complex manufacturing sites at 100 million euros of value, for instance, or even this is not reasonable to properly assess the risk of such sites fully remotely. This is something that we can do remotely spending time, but through risk scanning, we are not recommending that. So you will see that there are some industries where risk scanning is more relevant than the others. Globally speaking, all the industries where you have either simple locations, low hazard type of location, or a lot of locations, very much applicable. We are speaking about the automotive trade sector. So small assembly plants, small metalworking, the car dealers, the parking lots, or the suppliers of the automotive sector. This is a trade sector where it is very much relevant. Retail industry, for instance, so retail distribution, something you might have a lot of retail stores, a lot of supermarkets, malls, which are, by the way, quite standard occupancies, facing other type of risk, like burglary and theft, water damage type of risk. Once again, very much relevant for risk scanning. The pharmaceutical industry is very much relevant for risk scanning as well. You might have a lot of small laboratories, storage locations, or once again, for the suppliers of the pharma industry, because the pharma industry very often is working with first tier and even second tier or third tier type of stuff. So all in all, you can see all the different trade sectors where risk scanning is of value. On the other side, there are some industry sectors where risk scanning is not relevant. EV industry, when we are speaking about foundries, complex sites, energy, big power plants, this type of location will not be a relevant for risk scanning. Ports and terminals. But you will see in the brackets of all these different trade sectors that we have identified for almost all trade sectors, type of locations where risk scanning would be very much relevant. And by the way, we are already serving the vast majority of these trade sectors through risk scanning. So this is the end of my presentation. Before we move to the Q&A session, let me give you a synthesis of risk scanning. So risk scanning is very much complementary to traditional risk engineering services. This would help WBN to acquire very large risk insights for their clients. So to be better positioned when selling the risk profile of their clients to insurers, this is the opportunity to differentiate on the market and to acquire new type of clients and to provide advice to these clients. So it's not only a tool and a service which will help you to better manage and conduct your today brokerage type of business, an opportunity to be closer to your clients and to better understand their business. Thanks again for your listening, and I'm now very pleased to open the Q&A session. Thank you very much.